In the next 15 minutes, I'm going to give you a secret. This is a secret that no scientist wants you to know. And I really hope that I won't be exiled from the scientific community for sharing it with you. As a scientist who does genetic editing experiments in the lab, almost on a daily basis, and I know it sounds crazy, but we do it almost every day. Genetic editing is totally legal. What if I told you that you can DIY genetically edit yourself at home? You don't even need a 4-year PhD in biomedicine or access to a research lab, because I also do that on a daily basis. I genetically edit myself every day to be lucky. And I don't do it in the lab. I could, but I'm pretty sure I would lose my job if I did. Disclaimer, my intention is really not to give you a motivational speech on how you create your own luck. I want to show you with empirical data that you can hack your DNA. And that's not all. I want to give you a 4-step guide on how to get lucky. No pun intended. So, the first one is being skilled at creating and noticing opportunities. Neuroplasticity is your brain's ability to reorganize and adapt by forming new neural connections in response to changes in your life, your experiences, and learning. So it's something that your brain does as a part of its healthy physiological functioning. Let's take a look at this audio by Dr. Diane Deutsch.
The sounds as they appear to you are not only different from those that are really present, but they sometimes behave so strangely as to seem quite impossible. But they sometimes behave so strangely.
Associations between concepts, it's something that your brain does naturally. Once you hear the melodic pattern in that audio, it's quite difficult to go back. If you go back and listen to it, it's almost impossible to unhear it. Just like this, our brain makes associations between concepts by forming new neural pathways almost every day, most of the time that we're unaware of. To resist these unconscious associations that might restrict our thinking rather than divert, we must be aware of their existence. To think against our own unconscious associations and biases is perhaps the true challenge when it comes to opening up our minds to opportunities. Essentially, in order for you to get an opportunity, you need to be receptive for when one appears. And let me tell you, no opportunity presents without a little bit of risk. Essentially, how your brain perceives and responds to potential opportunities with subsequent risks and rewards is controlled by a neurotransmitter called dopamine. I'm sure we've all heard of it at some point. It's the happiness hormone. Our body makes it, and our brain uses it to send signals between neurons. Research has shown that an increased amount of dopamine makes you more likely to take risks. But risk-taking doesn't necessarily have to be skydiving or gambling. It just means seizing an opportunity. Interestingly, whether the outcome is successful or not doesn't even matter, because it's more the pursuit and anticipation of success that feeds your motivation. So here we come across a positive feedback loop, the holy grail of biology. Consequently, the depletion of dopamine has been linked with burnout in many studies. But what does all of this mean, I can hear you asking. It means that by making small changes in your life in order to keep your dopamine levels in check, you can be more receptive and motivated for when an opportunity arises. And how do we do that? For instance, getting enough, but also good quality sleep. A team of researchers from Japan and China reported in 2022 that right before entering into the REM cycle of your sleep, there is a huge surge in dopamine production in your brain, supporting healthy physiological wakefulness and sleepiness. Meaning that a lack of dopamine can disrupt your dopamine system, a lack of sleep, excuse me, can disrupt your dopamine system entirely. Opportunities are ever present. All you might need to do is get a good night's sleep and have the right amount of dopamine to be able to seize them. Now, I want to talk to you about the second common trait of self-proclaimed lucky people, which is listening to your intuition. This is my personal favorite. But in order for you to listen to it, it might first help distinguish what your intuition is from what might potentially be schizophrenia. Don't just listen to all the voices in your head. Essentially, your intuition is your survival instinct. It's an evolutionary souvenir. That little voice that told our ancestors to find shelter if they don't want to be removed from the gene pool by voracious predators eventually evolved into the voice that tells you not to post that selfie on Instagram if you don't want to get canceled. So how can you turn up the volume on this instinct, sixth sense, gut feeling, however you may want to call it? Well, the answer is figuratively, but also literally taking care of this gut feeling. So yeah, the gut-brain axis is the bidirectional relationship between your central nervous system, so your brain, and your gastrointestinal tract, so your gut. Research into the gut has yielded in our extensive knowledge today on the gut microbiota, the complex community of microbes, microorganisms inhabiting your gut. These microbes include various types of bacteria, viruses, fungi, and many others. And there are up to 100 trillion of them living in your gut as we speak. So much so that the bacterial genes in your body are 100 times more than your own. And no, they don't want to make you sick. They want to keep you healthy. They want to maintain your health in all aspects. These microbes, they're in direct communication with your brain via neurotransmitters that they produce, via your immune system, and your energy metabolism. According to a paper published in the Frontiers of Gastroenterology, changes in your gut microbiota, such as compositional and functional changes, induced by diet, stress, and drugs, in turn modulate your brain at both the behavioral and functional level. More specifically, reduction in microbial richness and diversity has been found in individuals with struggling with anxiety. How can we take care of this gut feeling via our gut microbiota, via taking care of our gut microbiota, in order to maximize our luck? Well, in accordance with the findings of this paper and what I personally do, the first thing is to avoid unnecessary use of antibiotics. Antibiotics, recurrent exposure to antibiotics, such as penicillins and quinolones, has been found to increase the risk of developing anxious and depressive behavior. The second thing to do is to take pre- and probiotics supplementations. So, prebiotics, which are essentially food for these microbes, and probiotics, which are live microorganisms supporting the healthy functioning of your gut, has been found to reduce risk of anxiety, systemic inflammation, stress, and increase overall well-being. And these are things you can easily find at supermarkets and pharmacies. The third thing, and the last, to do to take care of your gut is to avoid a high-fat diet. A diet rich in saturated fat has been found in individuals has been found to increase the risk of anxious and depressive behavior, developing and persistence of this behavior via your insulin and leptin metabolism, as well as inflammation in the brain. Now, finally, let's do some genetic editing. The third way in which lucky people create their own luck is via self-fulfilling prophecies and positive attitude. A self-fulfilling prophecy is another positive feedback loop in its essence. It goes hand in hand with optimism. But where does genetics come into play? According to a study published in 2011, a variant of the oxytocin receptor gene has been linked with sensitivity to stress and reduced social skills. The oxytocin receptor is another molecule whereby oxytocin, so another happiness hormone, exerts its effects in the body. And consequently, the other variant of this gene has been found in individuals with increased optimism and self-esteem. And genetics, on average, plays only about a 50% role on whether you turn out to be optimistic or pessimistic. The rest is 40% the way in which your lifestyle choices, and 10% the way in which you were brought up. But are we only 50% in control of our outlook on life and therefore luck? I beg to differ, because there's something really cool called epigenetics. Epigenetics is the key to hacking your DNA. It's the jump between what your genes tell you you're capable of doing and what you're willing to do. Thanks to epigenetics, we're able to turn our genes on and off throughout our lives. And it's you who is in full control, because it's your lifestyle choices and experiences that turns this switch on and off. According to another paper published in 2017, genetically switching off of this oxytocin receptor gene, regardless of which variant you carry, has been linked with pessimism and distrust. And as I said, it's you who switches this on and off. It's your diet, your exercises, your stress, your smoking, and exposure to drugs and environmental chemicals. I'm going to show you something that I never thought I would show anyone, but you have to promise me to keep it a secret between us, okay? At the very... I know this is a perfect photo for a TED Talk, but... At the very right-hand side of this picture is me at age 11, just having been diagnosed clinically with diabetes. This was a particularly difficult time in my life, given that at that age, physical and mental activity, participating in all these things is very difficult for your, it's very important for your healthy functioning, and growing up, it's truly been a challenge. But shortly after this very bad quality video was recorded in 2011, I made the necessary lifestyle choices in order to overcome this personal challenge for me, to genetically edit my luck rather than blame bad genetics. So, which one are you going to choose? Now, let's make a quick recap. So, the first thing I said was that we need to open up our perception to opportunities. To do that, we need to get a good night's sleep and have the right amount of dopamine. And the second thing I said, that we need to take care of our gut feeling. And to take care of our gut feeling, we need to literally take care of our gut by those three ways I mentioned. And the third thing is to adopt a positive outlook on life. The fourth and last way in which lucky people edit their biology is resilience, which has this magical ability to transform bad luck into good. Much like your intuition, resilience is what underlies life and evolution itself. It's the survival of the fittest, the one best adapted to stress. Going back into the microscopic point of view, where everyday resilience is essential to survival, bacteria have this insane ability to transfer genes between each other. They do this to acquire resilience genes against drugs that target them, as you can see in the slide. And this is called horizontal gene transfer. This is perhaps the most primitive yet noteworthy form of stronger together. So bacteria can tell us that maybe next time we need that extra bit of resilience, we shouldn't hesitate when calling up a good friend, a family member, or a complete stranger. Bacteria can tell you that it's a foolproof method. 9 months ago, my partner, who is a national team basketball player, experienced a devastating injury. This injury meant that he couldn't play for at least a year, and that the road ahead was difficult and long, with first his surgery, and then between daily physiotherapy and rehabilitation appointments, later on with high performance fitness, and all the while studying engineering. Needless to say, I was quick to make a decision. I drove every day, almost every day, 400 kilometers back and forth between Netherlands, where I was living at the time, and Luxembourg, all to be there for him, both physically and mentally, because I knew that he needed that resilience from me that I could lend him. 2 months ago, I was experiencing what was probably the most financially difficult time of my life to date. yeah. I know, there's probably going to be a lot more. But so we had experienced a robbery. My car broke down, all the while being in the process of buying my own place at age 22. So he was quick to provide me with that same resilience that I had lent him earlier on in the year by taking care of everything that I was too overwhelmed to. And just like this, we got through to our respective challenges by lending each other resilience, and we turned our temporary bad luck into good. So you see, luck is in our nature. It's in our DNA. It's in our genes. It's in our cells running through our veins. All we might need to do is remember how to, or learn how to harness it at best to in a more modern context, maybe. By actively altering your biology to first opening up your perception to opportunities, to second, listening to your intuition, to third, adopting a positive outlook on life, and to finally maximizing your resilience, you will create your own luck. So, are you willing to break your own barrier and genetically edit yourself to be lucky? Or are you going to sit back and watch and relax while science catches up to do it for you? That's my question to you. Thank you.